The Notre Dame de Paris, one of the oldest church, one of the oldest cathedral in Paris. Right now we are entering through the security check. They are setting up for the Christmas ceremony. There is the main altar. Look at the height of the cathedral. It is considered one of the finest Gothic architecture, where you can see the pillars supporting the weight of the dome. The shape of the arch make it possible to the construction of such height because of the distribution of weight and the use of flying buttresses. Later I will explain it in detail. Here is the confession room. There used to be, right now it also has, means that once you have conducted something wrong, some sins, you can come here to make confessions towards the people of God and they will guide you through your fault. That's the grand organ used during the mass ceremony, so they get the mighty and music, grand music for the mass. In altar, there the shape is like a cross, and from the top it looks like a cross. You have the sideward chapels. Okay, let's get out of here. And this is the rear end of the cathedral. So this explains the construction of the cathedral. Here we have some miniature statues depicting the medieval lives of Parisian, I think. So medieval houses, medieval style clothing, medieval daily activities. She's busy washing the clothes, and the bakery shop. He must have had a very tiring day. Carpenter, fabric weaver, weaving fabric out of thread. The stained glass, giant stained glass that's in rose shape. Here's another one. Great paintings, religious paintings. Over there we have a structure which I don't know what's the purpose of it. Kings has been coronated here, Cathedral Notre Dame, including Napoleon, which you will see the painting of it in Musée du Louvre.
OK， 这就是巴黎圣母院。让我解释一下一点点有关系到圣母院建筑构造的那个意义啊。我们有三个门，那个门上面的那个坐着是中间那个一是耶稣，然后右手边那边呢其实是恶魔的象征啊。你看耶稣下面坐着一个恶魔，左边是一个天使，所以每次人家进去祈祷的时候呢，他们经过这个门。 他们会想到，如果做善事的话，我们就会去左边；做坏事就会去右边，这样子，一直时时提醒着人们。然后上面呢，这些呢都是圣人。话说以前在大革命时期呢，宗教和国王的那个君主制度呢都被废除了，所以他们很讨厌有关系到宗教的建筑。 所以他们把那些圣人的头都砍下来，一一砍下来。还好有一个学者，他偷偷把那些头给收藏在他家后院。所以一直到1980多年、1970多年年代呢，他们在。 人们才在那个学者的家后院发现到那些头颅，然后再把它接回去。那个最大最上面玫瑰的图像，那旁边你可以看到四周围有一个叫 gargoyles， 还是它的作用是为了防止恶魔进入教堂里面，好像当做一个守护神这样子。那我们看到这边有一个很特别的人物，就是为什么他的头会拿在手上呢？据说以前在罗马时代，基督教是一个很被人看不起的宗教啊，那个时候基督教才刚盛行，所以很多人罗马人都很怕基督教取代他们罗马教，所以呢一旦只要有人传教，他们就把他砍掉，砍头钉在十字架上。那这一位圣人呢，他就是因为传教，那罗马人把他抓起来了，他还是不放弃，就是继续传教，所以结果罗马人把他的头给，据流传所说呢，他的头被砍了掉在地上，他还是可以活着把头举起来，然后继续去传教。所以这个The statue of King Charlemagne. He was the king of France and Germany. Charlemagne established the base of modern France, and some part of the kingdom eventually became like the part of Holy Roman Empire, which today covers Germany, France.As a support for the heavy weight of the main structure. This is the wall, and if it's built too tall, it will become heavy and it will crumble outward. So the flying buttresses act like this and give it a support towards the main body structure. Rear inside the backyard of Notre Dame Cathedral.